Hi, you probably have heard from many different sources about SSD or solid-state drives and how great they are. But is it true or just another marketing campaign planned to drain your wallet? I compared a solid-state drive with a traditional 3.5-inch hard disk drive in my own computer and made this video. At the end, I will tell you why I didn't take the laptop 2.5-inch hard drives into consideration. Let's start from a few well-known facts about both competitors. In hard drives, information is written on and read from rotating magnetic platters by moving heads. The motor and the actuator that moves the heads produce noise, especially while reading from the disk. Hard drives shouldn't be exposed to vibrations and shocks, as it may shorten their lifespan or even cause damage. Unlike hard drives, solid-state drives contain no moving parts. In fact, if you look inside, there's nothing more than just a PCB with a few flash memory chips where all your files are stored. That's why they are completely noiseless and a lot less susceptible to mechanical damage than hard drives. But what if the disk is about to fail? In case of a hard drive, you can sometimes notice something bad is happening to it. It may click at times or a few of your files are inaccessible, missing or corrupted. Some other time your operating system may not boot and show you an error like disk boot failure, insert system disk and press enter. In many such cases, you can simply copy most of your files and folders to another hard drive. If you're unlucky and the electronics fries, your drive will be completely inaccessible. There are many companies specializing in data recovery, and in majority of cases, they will be able to get your files back. These services are not cheap, but your files may be worth more for you. The SSD, which is about to fail, is quite different, because there is usually no warning at all. In most cases, when it fails, it happens instantly, and the computer can't recognize the drive anymore. You probably won't be able to recover even one file at home. The data recovery companies may retrieve your files, but such operation is usually a few times more expensive than for hard drives. I'll just remind you that you will avoid the data recovery problem for both disk types if you always have an up-to-date backup. Now, let's compare capacity and prices. The highest capacity SSD I've seen is 1 TB, while it's 4 TB for a hard drive. If you have $50 to spend, you can buy one of the cheapest 120GB SSDs or 1 TB hard drive. As you can see, the SSDs are about 8 times more expensive per 1GB of space. Solid-state drives are best known for their speed, so let's compare this last but not least parameter. I installed one copy of Windows 10 Technical Preview on my 128GB OCZ Vertex 4 and another one on my 1TB Western Digital Black. I went through a series of tests and gathered all the results on my website. I will mention only a couple examples so you don't get bored. The Windows installation process took 12 minutes and 55 seconds on my SSD, while 24 minutes and 58 seconds on my hard drive. If you want to run GIMP, it will take 11 seconds for the SSD and 19 seconds for the hard drive. Synthetic benchmarks were merciless for the hard drive. SSSD benchmark, for example, rated the solid-state drive for over 1100 points, while the hard drive got a whopping 36 points. Windows on the SSD boots in 12 seconds, while the hard drive needs 51 seconds. What's more, the hard drive is almost totally unresponsive for about 30 seconds after your desktop appears, while the SSD is ready to work without a delay. Even worse is the fact that the hard drive will become slower over time due to file fragmentation. SSDs don't suffer from performance loss, and you should never defragment them. It turns out that the hard drive is as fast as a rushing snail, while the SSD is a real speed demon. I promised I would tell you why I didn't consider 2.5-inch hard disks in this comparison. The reason's very simple. Their capacity is much lower and they are even slower than 3.5-inch disks, so the results for 2.5-inch hard drives would be absolutely terrible. At this point, I should reveal the winner. So my verdict is... there is no winner. SSDs and hard drives differ a lot, but there is enough room on the market for both technologies, at least for now. The SSD is a much better choice for the system drive, where you install the operating system and all or most needed programs. You can add more RAM, buy a new processor, and you may barely notice any performance boost in everyday use. When you add an SSD as the system drive, it usually feels like your computer got a new life. Your OS and programs start a lot faster, and the system is much more responsive. It works the same way even for much older computers, so if you need an upgrade, the SSD is a wise choice. The hard drive is still the best way to store large amounts of data, like videos, photos, music, backup copies, and much more. Your precious files should be a little bit safer, and you won't spend a fortune for 1 or 2 terabyte drive. If you find this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to my channel to be notified about new videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.